Hi, Knox County families. My name is Erin McCullum, and I teach STEM K through 5 at Sequoia Elementary. As you know, the Summer Olympic Games were to take place this summer, but they have been postponed until next year. Our STEM challenge today is in honor of the Olympic athletes who have worked hard to train for their events. So let's learn a little bit more about one of those events called the javelin throw. We're going to use the engineering design process and our measurement skills to create a javelin that we will throw to reach a specified distance. You might be wondering what a javelin throw is. It's a track and field event, and the javelin itself is 260 centimeters in length and weighs about 800 grams. A javelin thrower gains momentum by running within a predetermined area and throws the javelin forward with a goal to achieve the farthest distance. I'm going to show you a video clip to learn more, but to give you a little idea of what 260 centimeters is, think about 8.5 feet. We're using the metric system today, not feet and inches. So we're going to be thinking of centimeters and meters. And then I also mentioned 800 grams. So grams is going to give us an idea of how much mass the javelin has. So 800 grams is the same as about 800 paper clips. So probably pretty lightweight, if you ask me. So watch this video clip to learn more.
The final in women's javelin in this field was 35-year-old Barbara Spodakova of the Czech Republic. She was gold medalist in this event in Beijing and again in London 2012. The early standard was set by the athlete from South Africa. Sunette Fouillon reached 64.92 meters on her first attempt. The distance stood until this. From Sarah Kolak of Croatia on her fourth attempt, she had height and distance. She cleared 66 meters to jump into first, smashing her own personal best and the record in her home country. Others challenged. Maria Andrzejczyk of Poland, who threw for over 67 meters in the qualifying stage, had a great effort here. She would see the javelin land just short of 65 meters. She finished in fourth. Then the two-time gold medalist and world record holder had a chance to make history. This throw would put Spodakova back on the podium, but not in top spot. Spodakova finished with bronze. The leader, Kolak, forced to wait and watch Fouillon's last throw. South African slipped in the rain and would settle for silver. Kolak, the new Olympic javelin champion.
So, did you notice how far the women threw their javelins? Do you think you could throw a javelin that far? So, that's one of our questions that we are going to ask today. So, let's define the problem. Here's your challenge. You've been hired by a sports engineering firm to create a prototype, or also known as a model, of the javelin that will be used in the 2021 Summer Olympic Games in Tokyo. Can you design a javelin that is between 10 centimeters and 30 centimeters in length and can travel a combined distance of 66 meters after 5 throws? So what does a sports engineer do anyway? They design sporting equipment that is lighter, faster, stronger, and safer. If you look at the first picture of the swimmer, she's wearing a swimsuit, a swim cap, and swim goggles. Those were all designed by sports engineers, as were the sneakers on the right-hand side. As we define our problem, we also want to know what we need to do to be successful in this task. So we need to think about the criteria, the outcomes that help solve the problem. So in the challenge I presented to you, we need to make sure the javelin travels a combined distance of 66 meters in 5 tries. Also, the movement should be smooth and straight. Constraints are the limitations to the solution, things that you're going to have to problem solve. For instance, the javelin must be between a length of 10 centimeters and 30 centimeters. Remember, we're not using inches and feet. And also, a combination of at least three materials will be used. So let's think about it for a minute. Do you have an idea of why I chose 66 meters as your combined distance? In the video, the gold medalist achieved a distance of 66 meters. So I want to challenge you to do the same. So one more time, let's remember we're using the metric system for this activity. Centimeters and meters, not inches and feet. So as we move along through the engineering design process, we're going to come to the next step, which is imagine. So I want you to brainstorm some possible solutions and what are some materials that you could use that you have around the house to build your javelin. Plan it out. Draw, sketch your design. Just find a scratch piece of paper and label your sketch with the materials you plan to use. Remember, you need to use at least three different materials. Some suggested materials I have for you could be straws, construction paper, paper clips, pennies, tape. I also put a measuring tape in there, not to build with or to use as part of your javelin, but of course you need to make sure you have one of these or something similar to help you measure. Here's my plan. I have paper clips, pennies, and construction paper that I used. Also, I did not label the tape, but tape was used as well. And I measured my javelin. It has a length of 30 centimeters. Now, something extra that you could think about, if you have a kitchen scale at home, you might want to measure your javelin's mass or weigh it. The weight might change as you make improvements, and I wonder how that might affect the distance you're able to throw your javelin. Here is my javelin. I've got my paper clips on either end, and I have taped my pennies to the body of my javelin, which is rolled up construction paper. Ready to create, test, and improve. You may want to pause the video now while you get to work, and then once you've finished testing and making your improvements, making it better, then it would be time for us to go into the second part of our challenge. Have fun and good luck. So here we are. You've got your javelin completed. You've tested it. You've made improvements. So let's see if we can answer this next question. Can your javelin achieve an Olympic gold distance? So in 2016, the women's javelin gold medalist threw a distance of 66.18 meters. We saw that in the video. Your task is to see how many combined meters you can throw in five tries. That word combined brings addition to mind. You're going to throw your javelin. You're going to measure the distance it went. You're going to record that distance on your piece of paper, and then all of your distances, you'll add them up to get a total distance. Let's see how we can put all this information in one spot. So you're going to want to record your measurements after each throw. So on my notepad, I have a T-chart to help me organize my information. In the left column, I have the trial numbers, and on the right, I have the distance that I threw the javelin. My first trial, I got 6 meters. I threw my javelin a distance of 6 meters. So I'm going to need some materials to make sure that I have what I need as I throw my javelin and record my measurements. So make sure you have a ruler or a tape measure, pencil, and scratch paper. You also could use some rocks to help you mark the meters. And cones work too, or maybe some chalk. You could mark the number of meters along your driveway. So plan out your field. How are you going to set up your space? so that you can measure the distance after each trial. Now, here is my data. I've got all 5 trials completed, and you'll notice that my distances are different for each trial. Why do you think my distance increased by 2 whole meters between trial number 2 and trial number 3? Also, my last trial, I got 16 meters. So, why do you think my distances increased? Well, I'll tell you. Between trial 2 and trial 3, I decided to make some changes to my javelin. I'd already improved my javelin before I started doing my trials, but once I got started, it really started making me think about some new ideas. So I stopped, made some more improvements to my design, and I ended up adding more pennies. Then I got more practice. As I kept throwing the javelin, my form got better and better, my technique. So the final trial is a pretty great distance, 16 meters. So I ended up between trial 4 and trial 5, I added even more pennies. So 16 meters is what I ended up with. I added up all of my distances for each trial, and I ended up getting a total of 48 meters. Did I achieve a gold medal distance? Well, let's reflect. I may not have won the gold medal, but I definitely learned a few things. Adding pennies to my javelin made it go further. Estimating the length of centimeters and meters is a little easier now. And I had to make a lot of improvements to get it to do what I wanted it to do. So how about you? What worked well and what was hard? What improvements did you make to get it to go that far distance? Did you achieve a gold medal distance? If the answer is no, like me, don't think about it as failing. I don't consider it a failure at all. I learned a lot, I had fun, and now if I were to do it again, I know what I would do differently next time. So, what new questions or ideas do you have now? It leads us back to our engineering design process. What was that first step again? Ask. That's right. I hope you'll share your javelin with us on Twitter. Thanks for being with me today. Bye-bye.